Hey everyone, and welcome back to another tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to build a bench. So let's get to it, shall we? First of all, you need a couple of wooden posts. Actually, hold on guys, I'll be back in a minute. Alright guys, I'm back. Sorry about that. Hold on again guys, sorry. Hey everyone, we're back. Hopefully for good this time. So yeah, you're gonna need a bucket of nails and some screws, a stepladder, and maybe even a little bit of glue. So yeah, you take your board up like this and put one screw into a board laying down like that. Hold on guys, I'm sorry. Alright, we're back guys, hopefully. Just forget it. You know what guys, I've been doing a lot of thinking, and I work from home right now, and I spend most of my time inside in the house. I don't really get to get out any at all, and I mean, I just do paperwork, I do a business online. I mean, I'd much rather be out here doing something outside in the trees and nature. I mean, in these pretty mountains and everything, especially now it's springtime. So I'm gonna see if I can find me another job. I'm gonna be looking in the next few weeks and see what I can find. So yeah, I'll let you guys know my progress at a little bit later date. So guys, it's now been 5 days since then, and I've found me a job, and it's gonna be farm work, but I mean, that doesn't really bother me, and it sounds nice. It's something I'll enjoy out here in nature, and I do have a little bit of experience working on tractors. I've done that before, so I mean, if I worked on them, I'm sure I can learn how to drive one. And I mean, I think it's just gonna be something I'll enjoy and stuff. So yeah, well, let's get to it, shall we? It's just right down the road, about 2 miles, so I'll just record as I go. I believe you take a left out of here. Like I say, everyone, I've had a little bit of experience working on tractors, so I used to run a machine shop in this town that, and the main, thing I got was, the main thing that people brought in was old tractors that I had to fix. So I mean, I'm sure if I can repair them, I can drive one, you know. I mean, it's harder to repair them than to drive them, so I know they're two different things, but I should be able to do it. And yeah, I think this guy's name is Don, so yeah. So I'll let you know when we get there guys. Well, right when I said that, we're already here. So, yep. Just that fast, I mean. It's definitely right down the road from me, so I'll be able to drive up here every day. So, I wonder what the best place to park would be. I guess right here. So, I'm gonna park it right here and get out and talk to him. I think his name is Mr. Don, so yeah. Hello, anyone there? Oh, hi there, Mr. Don.
Hey, Woody, nice to finally meet you. My name is Don.
I mean, I'm looking so forward to, starting my work here. I mean, I just want to get out and enjoy the, fresh air and stuff, you know? So, yeah, I guess I'm ready to start work today.
I've heard a lot about you. Seems like you know how to fix tractors and implements. But do you know how to be a good farmer?
Well, I mean, I can always learn. I mean, I haven't ever driven a tractor, but I'm sure I can. Well, I mean, I've driven just a couple little ones, but I haven't really driven any big ones, so. But I'm sure I can learn. I mean, if I can fix them, I can definitely drive them.
Well, here is your first job, Woody. Go and plow as many fields as you can. You can see all my own fields on this GPS here.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, this is his fields that he owns. So, yeah. I wonder what the best tractor would be. Let me go over here and look at this equipment real fast and see what he has. That truck right there looks almost like mine. I'm gonna go ask him. Well, I guess the tractor he'll pull it. I'm not sure. Let me look up the way this plow real fast on my phone here. So yeah, let's go to I'm currently looking online just to see cultivators. Requires 400 horsepower, and the tractor is a 3T. Let's go look. Let's look. There we go. Fendt 3T Vario. Okay. Let me look here and see what I can find. Go back under tractors. It's probably under small. There we go there. Ooh, that's definitely not enough to pull it. I'm gonna have to go speak with him and tell him that tractor is not gonna pull that plow. So, yeah. Yeah, let me go and speak with him real fast. So guys, he seems like a nice fellow. He, basically what he said was that he would just, buy a bigger tractor. So yeah. I'm just gonna walk down here and go pick it up. This one he bought was a little bit under the horsepower required, but I think it'll work. It's a pretty big tractor, so drive good on these roads here because it's such a big tractor. But yeah, we'll see. So this right here is it, the Fendt 1038 Vario. This one right here is definitely big enough to pull it. So yeah, let's go over there. Yeah, this tractor right here, I don't know. I guess it'll drive fine on these roads. You just gotta be careful. Alright, let's move this one out of the way. Hook it back up to this. Alrighty. Raise this up and move it over here. Okay. Let this down. I know you're supposed to like do that before you take it off because it helps to take some of the pressure off the tractor, but you really don't need to unless it's loaded down. But I mean, I just do it anyway. Alright, here we go. Let me get that straightened. There we go. Should be good. Yep. Okay. Okay, and connect the hoses. There we go. See, yeah, look, I'm meant to, like, be a farmer. I'm meant to do this. So, yeah, let's just drive over here, and this is our first field, I believe. I believe he owns this one, yep. Okay. Let's get to work, shall we? That's the right button, yep. Okay. Wait, hold on. I think that that button right there enabled the GPS on the stretcher. Okay, there we go. So yeah. Looks like it's doing a pretty good job. So I'm just gonna keep on going along here and get it done. And you said do as many as you can do, so I guess we're gonna work on into the night, possibly. So yeah, I'll see you guys when I get a little bit more of this field done. Alright everyone, we're done with that field. Moving on to this next one over here. I'm pretty sure these are crops in here, so but yeah, they're definitely withered. Mr. Don might have not owned this field last year or something. Yeah, I don't know why this field was not harvested, or the one behind me. Might not have been a good yield or something, but still, that seemed like a waste to me. Anyway, yeah, I can't believe Mr. Don thought that this tractor could pull that plow, or that hair. It definitely wouldn't. Anyway, let's continue, shall we? That finishes up this field. Onward to this other one over here. And let it down, and we're off. I hope to make a pretty good bit of money today. Hopefully I will. I don't know. Anyway, let's continue. You're calling me to pull me out of the darkness and pull me out of the
desires of your heart. I do not deserve a thing, but that's just who you are. I was a dead man walking until I was a man walking with you. I was a blind man falling until I found the light. You're calling me to pull me out of the darkness and pull me out of the lies, putting the beat in my heart again. I was a dead man.
Hello everyone, welcome back. So, obviously I need to eat something to eat, so I'm going to stop for a minute, and I'm going to go back over here and ask Mr. Don if he'll just take like $20 out of my pay and I can eat with him, and see if he'll cook me up something up real fast. So yeah, I will let you guys know when I get back. Guys, I'm back. That sure was good. So anyway, I'm going to continue with the herring. I told Mr. Don how far I got, and he seemed to be pretty excited, if that's the word you want to use. Pretty astonished. So where are the next fields at? Next fields are south here. Okay. So if I just take this road, this should lead me to where I'm going. And yes, I probably should put my beacons on. And that was probably a smart move. So this right here is our next field.
And yeah, I'll let you guys know when I complete a little bit more.
I want you as you are, not as you ought to be. Won't you lay down your guard and come to me? The shame that grips you now is crippling. It breaks my heart to see you suffering. 'Cause I am for you, I'm not against you. If you wanna know how far my love can go, just how deep, just how wide. Look at my hands, look at my side. If you could count the times that say you aren't forgiven, it's more than the drops in the ocean.
Hey everyone, so I have finished this field here, and I think I'm gonna do one or two more fields before I quit. Let's move on to this other one here. This right here is a boring job, but I'm sure I'm gonna get a good payment for it. Alright, so I'll see y'all when I get a little bit more done.
Ocean.
Everyone, we're back, and it's getting late. It's 10 o'clock at night, but I saw this one little short field over here. I'm not going to do that one tonight, but I'm going to finish this one up. You gotta work while you can, guys. So yeah, I'm going to finish this one up, and then that's going to be it. So, I'll let you guys know when I've completed this field.
If you wanna know how far my love can go, just how deep, just how wide. If you wanna see how much you mean to me, look at my hands, look at my side. If you can count the times and say you are forgiven, it's more than the drops
everyone. So I'm back, and I turned the lights on in the house and everything, so I got it nice and cozy in there. So yep, I will see you guys tomorrow on my next video. Until then, have a safe, nice, and wonderful day, and God bless. Bye.